Hi, this is Catherine Rosen here with Board Game Geek TV at Spiel 2014. I'm sitting here with Christian Amundsen-Østby from Aporta Games, and he's here to talk about Doodle City.
Yes.
Could you just give me a light overview of the game?
Yes, I'll do that. Doodle City is a family game for 1 to 6 players, and it's about city building, and it has a little puzzle element to it.
Okay.
So it's playable in about 30 minutes, 15 to 30 minutes.
Yeah.
So should I go and explain how the game works?
Yeah, that sounds great.
Yeah. Each player has their own sheet of paper, like this. Each player will build their city by building a network of roads through their city. So at the beginning of each turn, one player rolls a set of dice, like this. Let's say I roll like this. And then each player, in turn, will pick one white die for themselves. And the blue die indicates the column in which each player must draw, and each white die will indicate one row. So if I pick these, I get to draw in this space, like this. And when I draw in the space, I have to draw a road, which either needs to be a curve or a straight line. So I can, for instance, draw like this, a road like this.
And you just make that decision on your own.
Yes. And I forgot to mention, at the beginning of the game, there are 5 parks in the city, and in each park there's a randomized road at the beginning of the game. So the setup of each game will be different,
depending on where the curve goes in each
yes.
of the
yeah.
and each park.
And if the dice point to a park, you do, instead of drawing a road, you add another house like this.
Some more houses, let me
yeah.
park. Now, how do you get points in the game?
Points. There are 3 ways to score points. There are the hotels. When you draw in a hotel space, like this,
mm-hmm.
you immediately check the number of roads going through that space. The 1, 2, 3, 4 means you score 4 points, or the number below, which in this case is 3 points.
So, and it includes the actual building
space.
Itself.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then you have the shops, and when you draw a road in the shop space, you count the number of connected houses. In this instance, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4 houses. And for the houses, for the shops, there's also a bonus. The first player to connect at least 3, 5, 7, or 10 houses circles the first player bonus for this
oh,
place.
That's great.
So all other players will cross out this bonus. And then you have the taxis. The taxis are scored at the end of the game, and for each taxi that is connected to another taxi, you score points.
All right, so if you have a 2 taxi connected here and you have 2 taxi connected here,
that would be 8, 16 points for the taxis. Yeah.
Great.
And then there are pollution. If you are not able to build on your turn, because you can only draw in each space once, if you're not able to do anything on your turn.
So for example, if all of these had been crossed
yes.
out and you
yeah.
had a 1.
Yes, you will lose a 3 due to pollution. And if one player runs out of trees, the game ends. And the game also ends if one player builds the highest, the most valuable hotel or the most valuable shop for 10 points. And also, if you roll a white 6, if
mm-hmm.
you choose a white 6, then you get to draw in any space in that column.
So the 6 is a wild card.
Yes, but that costs you a 3.
Ah.
Yeah.
What if you roll a blue 6?
When you roll a blue 6, every player can choose from for themselves which column they want to build.
But do you have to cross off a tree?
Not when
no
not,
tree.
Not
All right, great.
Yeah.
So about 30 minutes, quick, easy game.
Yes.
But it seems to have a little bit of a depth to it.
Yeah, it's there's a puzzle element to it. You need to work out the ideal network for the road, and also the order in which you draw in these spaces.
How many players does it play?
1 to 6 players.
So you can play it as a solo game
you
as well.
You can do that. Yeah.
That's interesting. I heard a rumor that you also have an app for the game.
You did?
Yeah,
we have an app over here. We released this app this week, and it's for free during the fair. So it's released.
Free during the fair.
Yeah, it's released on App Store, so it's only available
for Apple products.
Yeah, on iOS for now. And we plan to expand on this game, but for now it's you can play local multiplayer or solitaire, or you can play online asynchronous multiplayer.
Okay, great. Yeah. So that's 3 great possibilities.
Yeah.
But there's no AI on the
No
on the
AI
app
opponents yet, but we plan to expand
yeah.
on the game with
great.
That. Yeah.
Great. Can you show how it works on the
Yeah,
on the app?
Now we're in the middle of the game. One player gets a roll. like this. And it shows which spaces you can draw. In this case, I can draw in the hotel space here, for example. I draw like this. And hotels pops up and you score points for the hotel.
Fantastic. I love the animations in this. It looks really nice.
Thank you.
Anything else you'd like to show about the app at all, or?
No. It's, I can recommend it.
You can recommend it. Yeah, it looks great. Do you guys have any more plans to make other games, or?
We have a few prototypes that we're working on.
But this is your only game so far.
This is our first game, yeah.
And this isn't the only game that you have under your belt either, though. You've made a few other games too.
Yeah, this year I have Escape Zombie City on Queen Games, and yeah.
So a well-known designer and a great new game. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's support a games with Doodle City.